Welcome to another webisode of Outdoor Cast Iron Cooking. I'm Dean, the Fog Crawler. The holidays are upon us, and I've got a craving to make some cinnamon rolls. Gotta satisfy that sweet tooth. Did you remember to turn your scales back 5 pounds for the holidays? This is gonna be fun. Stay tuned. I heated up some milk. You need your milk to be warm to activate the yeast. I take it up to about 100 degrees. They say you can go as high as 110. I don't like going that far. But what I do is put the warm milk in, put the yeast in, put the sugar in. I'll give this a quick stir, and then I'm going to be watching for the proof that my yeast is activated. It'll start foaming. The yeast is foaming, so I can add 2 beaten eggs. Quarter of a cup of melted butter. Now we're going to stir this up to an even consistency. Then we'll start adding the flour, a little bit of potato flakes, and a little tiny bit of salt to make our dough. Now I can start adding the flour. I'll be adding in total 3 cups of flour, 1/2 cup of potato flakes, and 1/2 teaspoon of salt. And once this forms a dough ball, I'll be transferring it to the cutting board and be kneading it by hand. Going to go ahead now and add the salt and the potato flakes. Then I'll finish it off with that last cup of flour. transfer it to the cutting board. I've greased my bowl. Now I'm going to put the dough ball in here. I'm going to turn it once so that the whole thing gets coated. Now I'm going to cover this and put it in a warm place to rise for an hour. The dough has been rising for an hour. It's doubled in size, so now we're going to turn it out on a floured board and roll it out. We want to end up with a 14 by 9 inch rectangle. That'll do it. Good there. I'm going to spread 1/4 cup of softened butter . And what I'm going to do is I'm going to stop short of this edge. I want to leave it plain dough so that I can seal the roll shut. If I put butter on it, it won't connect. Won't get those gluten fibers going across it. Next, I'm going to sprinkle the filling mixture And I'm just going to pat this in to the butter. Now we're going to roll it up. And we want to press this real good to connect. A little trick I've learned is just take a little water. That'll make the connection good and strong. So now we can take our knife and cut our rolls. Do a fatty. I'm going to place these in the Dutch oven and let them rise for 30 minutes. I placed 3 coals underneath the oven and 4 on the lid. I just need to warm this up a little bit so those will rise. I have 12 coals underneath the oven, and I'm going with 2 tight rings on the lid. We're going to let this bake for 25 minutes. The cinnamon rolls have been on for 25 minutes. Let's take a look. Oh, they're looking awesome. Time for the frosting. Now all we got to do is frost these. These front 4, I put a sugar glaze on them first. Well, I hope you enjoyed today's webisode. If you have a sweet tooth and it needs fixing, these baked holiday cinnamon rolls are the ticket. We'd like to wish all our viewers happy holidays. We got a surprise for you. We got each and every one of you a Christmas present. You just got to watch the end of the video to get it. Meli kliki maka. Gul you. Merry Christmas. Remember, it's all about eating good in the great outdoors. Until the next time, happy trails to you.